In this video, you will learn how to use this type of motor driver module, which is based on L298N IC. Don't get confused with L293D IC. This is different motor driver IC, which can handle current up to 0.6 ampere per channel. The main advantage of this L298N driver is that it can withstand current up to 2 ampere per channel. Now let's see how to use this motor driver module. This motor driver module and the similar ones like these uses L298N motor driver IC, which can be used to control two simple DC motors simultaneously or one stepper motor. In all these modules, you will see two set of output terminals, some input pin headers, and one set of terminal for giving power to motors and IC control circuit. First, let's see how to power up this module. In the power terminal, you will see written 12 volt, ground, and 5 volt. You have to give 12 volt or voltage rated for your motors in 12 volt terminal. Here we are connecting 6 volt power supply. After that, give 5 volt to 5 volt terminal of IC control circuit. If you don't want to give separate 5 volt power supply and want to use internal 5 volt regulator, then connect this 5 volt jumper in the module. Now let's see how to control simple DC motor. For that, connect one motor in OUT1 OUT2 terminal or OUT3 OUT4 terminal. Here we will connect in OUT1 OUT2 terminal. Next, to control motor connected in OUT1 OUT2 terminal, we have to use ENA, IN1 and IN2 pin headers. But if you have connected the motor in OUT3 OUT4 terminal, then you have to use IN3, IN4 and ENB pin headers. Now, if you only want to control the direction of motor and not the speed, then put the jumper in the ENA terminal of the motor driver. But if you also want to control the speed, then remove the jumper and connect the ENA pin to any of the PWM pin of the Arduino board, like pin 3, 5, 6, 9, 10, 11. Here we will connect ENA pin to pin 3. Next, connect IN1 and IN2 to any Arduino digital pins. Let's connect it to Arduino pin 4 and 5. At last, connect ground pin of the Arduino board to ground of the motor driver module. Now, hardware connection is done. Let's move to the coding part. To make the programming easier, we will use library. To install the library, go to Tools, Manage Libraries, then search for L298N. Install this L298N library. After that, in the code, first include L298N.h library. Then make an object of L298N class, let's say motor1, and then in bracket we will write 3 pin numbers. First should be the Arduino pin number with which ENA was connected, that is 3, followed by the pin numbers with which IN1 and IN2 is connected, that is 4 and 5. Next, we can write code to control the motor. For that, we have to know about 4 functions. The setSpeed function will decide the speed of the motor. The speed set point is passed as a parameter. It can take values from 0 to 255, like setSpeed 200. Please note that this function will not rotate the motor, it will only set the speed in which the motor will run. To start rotating the motor, we have to use forward or backward function. Forward function will start the motor to rotate in one direction. Backward function will rotate the motor in other direction. And stop function will stop the rotation of motor. Using these functions, you can control the DC motors. Let's write a simple code which will rotate the motor in one direction for 2 seconds, then stops it for 1 second, and again starts rotating in opposite direction for 2 seconds, next stops it for 1 second, and then repeats the process. For that, in the loop section, write object name, that is motor1.setSpeed100. This will set the speed to 100. Now, to start rotating, write motor1.forward. This will rotate the motor in one direction. Then use delay function to wait for 2 seconds. Next, to stop the motor, write motor1.stop. Wait for 1 second using delay function. Now, to rotate in opposite direction, write motor1.backward. Then again, wait for 2 second using delay function. Next, write motor1.stop. Then use delay function again to wait for 1 second. Now let's upload the code and see how the motor rotates. Set the correct board, port, programmer and upload the sketch. You can see the motor is rotating as desired. Now let's connect other motor in OUT3 OUT4 terminal and rotate both of them. Next, go to Arduino IDE and write code for the second motor. After that, we have to upload the code. Now you can see both motors are running. In this way, you can control two simple DC motors individually using this motor driver. If you found this video helpful, then please give this video a like and share it. If you have any doubts or questions or need any help, then feel free to ask in the comment section. Until then, stay safe and stay healthy. Meet you in the next video.